So Google gave us 10 of the most asked questions in the world, ranging from what is the meaning of life, to how do I get rid of hiccups, and we here at SciShow have answered them. But what about your most asked questions? The things that you, our audience, are curious about? We've gotten a lot of questions in the last few weeks, and I'm gonna answer 10 of them as fast as I can. First, you close your eyes when you sneeze because you do. It's certainly not to keep your eyeballs from falling out of your head, a terrifying myth that we tell to children. The sneeze response is complicated and involves a lot of muscle contractions. For some reason, your eyelids are part of those contractions. It might have some evolutionary advantage. It might just be that your face nerves are so convoluted, it's simpler for your brain to just contract everything during a sneeze. New car smell comes from the slow release of volatile organic compounds used in the manufacturing of the car. These compounds include paints and lacquers and glue and leather treatments and petroleum-based materials used in upholstery like vinyl and polyester. One sampling found over 60 different gaseous compounds in the interior of a new car. Their concentration drops by about 90% in the first 3 weeks. Next, you are one of the few animals that can grow hair indefinitely, by which I mean there is no maximum length for the hair on your head. No wild animals have hair that grows without stopping, for obvious reasons. It gets matted and tangled and terrible. But our head hairs, and the hairs of some animals that we've bred to grow more beautiful or useful hair, are the only hairs that don't know when to stop. Most follicles have a rest phase during which hairs stop growing, and the end of the hair breaks at the root. It stays attached until the next growth phase pushes out the hair. But our head hair just doesn't ever rest. Hey, fizzy drinks in microgravity. Luckily, NASA has studied this. Check out this bubble of water eating an Alka-Seltzer tablet. Basically, the bubbles just go everywhere and push into each other, creating bigger and bigger bubbles until those bubbles break or are broken. Pretty cool. Also on the fluid front, cold water is not bad for you. It's just maybe very slightly less good for you. Water is absorbed by your body in the large intestine. Depending on how much food you've got in you, it can take anywhere from 5 to 100 minutes for it to get there. On the low end of that time scale, the water might still have some of its original temperature when it gets to your lower GI tract. At that point, if it's still quite cold, it will be absorbed slightly more slowly than it otherwise would be. But really, people have made way too big of a deal about this. Do not worry about it. Oh, brain transplants. Well, we have transplanted heads, monkey heads and dog heads, in experiments that were seen as unethical even when they were done. It stopped, haven't happened since the 1970s. Brain transplants are way more complicated than that because of all the complicated set of nerves and vasculature necessary to connect all the stuff together, but I'm not gonna say it's impossible. Just that it's definitely a bad idea. And why do we need sensations? Well, sensing hot and cold are useful because both of those things are dangerous. What we sense as hot is higher than ideal temperature, and what we sense as cold is lower than ideal temperature. Ideal for us, for humans, pretty egotistical, but there you have it. As for why those feelings feel what they feel like, that's one of the great mysteries. We know why we feel the things, but we don't know why they feel the way they feel. Probably, there is simply no reason. Genetic mutations occur for a bunch of reasons, but broadly, just because your entire genome has to be copied in each of the billions of cells you create every day, and that is a lot of transcription, so every once in a while, something's gonna go wrong. Occasionally, that could be caused by some solar radiation or some obnoxious chemical that got into your body somehow, but mostly, it's just little accidents. And it really is remarkable that it doesn't happen more often. If you got water in your ears and you don't want to jump around like a weirdo, my suggestion to you is just jump around like a weirdo. Get over it, it's fine. Finally, number 10. If you drilled a hole through the planet, it would immediately fill with magma, and the intense pressure placed on all that magma would cause it to shoot out both sides of the planet in two gigantic volcanoes. If you jumped in before the volcano happened, you would quickly die. If you jumped in after, you would quickly die. Either way, you wouldn't die so quickly that you wouldn't experience a great deal of pain. Formal, full explanation of what would happen if you had like a reinforced wall around it, you can check out this collaborative video from our friends at Minute Physics and Vsauce, who are awesome. Thanks to everyone who asked such wonderful and weird questions. You can watch more of the world's most asked questions here, and don't forget to go to youtube.com/scishow and subscribe.